too. So I wrote in the email, if you want to utilize a crystal to help the efforts of your practice of this series keep going, feel free to get that out. I don't think to do this with every series, but you can do this with anything. So if you want to, you can hold your crystal in your hands at any moment during class, but I'll just tell you what to do now in case you want to do it now. And you simply ask for the teachings and the benefits and the energy of this series to keep going throughout your life. And then you can simply say, I program you to keep this going. Keep it going in my body, in my mind, in my spirit. And then you can place that crystal in a sunny window or anywhere that feels like the right spot.
Is this one big enough?
That's a nice big one, Mom. Yeah. Good. All of us are ready now. Feel free to just go through that in your own way. And you can clear your crystal of this programming at any time. So you might like to keep it going for a week. You might like to keep it going for a year. Good. And when that feels complete, you can just place your crystal near your mat for now. And then you'll find the right spot for it at some point. I'm going to mute us all and we'll tune in. Rub your palms together, sit up nice and tall. The straighter your spine, the more your instrument of your body will resonate as you tune in. Bring your palms together at heart center, lifting your heart, gazing at your third eye center in between the two eyebrows, and a little bit inward towards the skull. And allow this mantra of Om Namo Gurudev Namo to resonate in your skull, maybe even in your spine as we tune in. Let's inhale together. Exhale all the way out. Tuning into the universe. Inhale for Om Namo. Om Namo Guru Te. Suspending this breath. Exhale, let it go. You can tune in to yourself and to the universe at any time with this mantra. Before class today, I kept going back and forth between these two kriyas, and I was like, in my mind. And I was like, why don't I just tune in? Tuned in, and then I was like, yeah, no more question. So feel free to utilize that throughout your life. This mantra is really, really great at helping you just come right into center with yourself. And the universe is you. You are the universe. So it's really the same thing. It's like you're tuning in to this whole vast universal energy and yourself at the same time. And you can always tune out with Satnam once you've had your chat with yourself, or once you've figured out what you were trying to figure out when you tuned in the first place. Ready? You're gonna lean back a little bit. Your thumbs are pointing towards you. Your palms are open. You're gazing down at the tip of the nose. Inhaling in four strokes. So, 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 so. Exhaling in four. Hung, 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 hung. Think it in your mind. Go. You're gazing down at the tip of your chin. Keep it going a little longer. This is for full trust. Inhale deep. Hold your breath, lift Mool Bandha, inviting energy up the spine through the crown. Inhale even more. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale to rise up. Let's come to standing. Come right up to the top of your mat. We'll come into two tree poses. One for the sun and one for the moon. Leaning onto your left foot, bend your right knee out to the side, your sun side. You can bring that foot all the way up to the groin if you want to, or let it rest on the calf or ankle, but never on the knee. Interlace all of your fingers except for your pointer fingers. Standing up nice and tall, take a few slow breaths. Inhaling Sat, exhaling Nam. Invite that sun energy to wash through the body. Inhale, get even taller, holding the breath at the top, internal kumbhak. Exhale, release. Right to the other side, left knee comes out to the side, your moon side. All the fingers interlace, except for those pointers, which are a continuation of your spine. Breathing in and out with Sat Nam, let that moon energy wash through the body. Inhale, extra deep, holding kumbhak. Kumbhak means hold. Exhale, let it go. Both feet touch the ground. Make them shoulder width apart, relaxing into all four corners of each foot. Inhale, reaching out and up, inviting that whole universe, sun, moon, and everything in between. Let the hands gently interlace and rest on the crown of the head. Inhale here, you're standing tall. Exhale, as your knees bend forward and your buttocks sit back and down, you might bend just this much or you might come all the way down, doesn't matter. Just inhale as you rise, Sat. Exhale. As you sink, crow, Nam. Keep your gaze a little bit high so that you don't end up slouching. Feel that center line of your body. Both sides working equally. Two more. Inhale, hold the breath. Squeeze the spine. Exhale. Inhale, reaching out and up. Exhale, hinge at your hips, reaching out and down. You can bring your hands to your bent knees. Okay, this is the buttocks bounce. Or your hands could come down to the ground. Or if you want the full expression, bring your hands together between your feet, reach them back, and then wrap your hands. Wrap your arms behind the backs of the knees and let your hands rest on your feet. Look forward no matter what position you're in. Good. Now bounce the buttocks 11 times, inhaling as the buttocks rise, exhaling as they bounce down. On 11, release, reach it out and up. Beautiful hinge coming back in for another round. Keep looking forward. 11 bounces. Couple more. Last one right here. Sit right down onto your sitting bones. Ooh. just 30 seconds, pause without fidgeting. Maybe close the eyelids, feel the moment. Eyelids float open. Come back to standing. Open your feet 3 feet apart. Let your toes jut out a little bit more than your heels. Let your arms open wide. Now keep your alignment. Your arms are in a T. As you tilt to one side, bringing the hand down to that leg, ankle, or maybe even to the foot. Good. Spending 10 seconds here. So if you inhale for 5 and exhale for 5, then you can ride your next inhale through center. And come over to the other side. You're adjusting your spine. The more that you're in alignment in your own body, the more you'll feel in alignment with everything else. This is like a warm-up Kriya today. Inhale to center. Hold the breath, lift that pelvic floor. Stretch through the arms. You're a bright light. Let it go. Come to seated on your mat or sheepskin. Let your legs cross in Sukhasana, easy pose. Okay. This one is for the magnetic field. Your space around you. You're going to lift your arms up 60 degrees and then let your hands open up like little saucers, like you're holding plates of abundance up on each hand. Good, now tuck your chin a little bit, draw it towards the back of your neck and begin breath of fire. Panting like a dog through the nose. Keep it going. You can even imagine a rainbow arcing from one hand up and over to the other hand. You're strengthening your arc line. Inhale deep, hold it, lift it, Exhale, let it go. The moment of letting go is just as important than the moment that we hold and put in the effort of lifting energy. Just allow that to equalize. Deepen your breath, inhaling Sat, exhaling Nam. You're welcome to stay in Sukhasana, or if it's comfortable, come sitting onto your shins in rock pose. Feel free to place a cushion between the sitting bones and the ankles if you need that for your legs. Bring your palms together at heart center. Now reach your right hand forward in front of you with the palm facing up. Now reach your left hand up and back behind you with the palm facing up. You're gonna be twisting a little bit, but you're gazing over your front palm. Breath of fire, panting like a dog through the nose. Feel abundant in your trust. Inhale deep. Hold it, stretch through the arms. Exhale, hands come to the heart. Other side, left hand reaches forward like an offering. Right arm reaches back like an offering. You're twisting, but gaze over your front palm. Breath of fire. Again, feel abundant in your trust. Inhale deep, stretch. Exhale, hands to the heart. Keep the pinky edges of your hands together as you let the palms open in front of you. Gently bow the head, gazing into the palms of the hands. Make your breath slow and smooth. On your next inhale, reach the hands forward and up. Then on your exhale, draw them back to the heart. Taking one more. Now lean forward, bringing your elbows down to the ground. If you have a cushion on your heels, you can take it away. Inch your elbows a little bit forward so that you're able to let your hands, let me scooch back so you can see me. Let your hands be facing up in front of you. The elbows are on the ground and your knees are on the ground. See if you can lift your toes off the floor. Continuing to gaze in the palms, inviting a sense of compassion. This life requires a lot of effort from us. Sometimes the hardest part is letting go and regaining trust. Admire yourself for all the times that you let go and trust. Longer here. Allow your back to have that arch that's happening. Maybe try to lift and broaden through your collarbone slightly. Inhale with me, holding the breath. Exhale, lower your feet, sink your sitting bones back by your heels, and let your palms come together in Guru Pranam. Let your forehead, your third eye center, come down to the earth. Let's offer one extra deep breath into the body. Slowly roll it up. Coming back into rock pose. Feel free to bring your cushion back underneath you. If it's better for you to be in easy pose, that's fine too. Just bring your hands to the knees. In rock pose, our hands are going to rest just before the knees on the thighs. Keeping your neck in neck lock and your chin stays level to the ground. Inhale as you flex your spine forward, shoulders glide back. Exhale as you flex your spine back. Inhale, sat. Exhale, nam. Maybe let your eyelids close, gazing at your third eye center. Invite your own rhythm to develop. The spinal flex accesses every chakra from root to crown, including your aura. Imagine all the colors of the rainbow throughout the body receiving this energy. Seconds. Go as fast as you comfortably can. Inhale deep. Hold it, lift more buns. Inhale even more, squeeze the spine. Exhale, let energy wash back down to the tailbone. No fidgeting, just pause. Let energy come to you. Deep inhale, slow exhale. Before we come into Shavasana, the last piece of this Kriya, we stand up and we shake the whole body to spread everything. So feel free to have your Shavasana props ready. And then come to standing. I like to have my feet shoulder width or hip width apart, and my heels are gonna bounce. Okay, so a subtle bend in the knees. Let that happen and let your shoulders and arms shrug. I'm bouncing a little bit on the soles of my feet. Good, let your hips go side to side. Shake everything out. Breathe deep so you're reaching every cell. Any self-doubt, anxiety, anything that's not serving you, heaviness, Let it go. A little bit faster. Reach the arms over the head. Seconds. Three, two, one. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, let the arms release into the mountain. Feel your body and your space. And feel your trust. This universe is your home. Lying down into Shavasana, palms facing up, legs separated. Let energy come to you. Surround you and hold you as you rest. gently deepen your breath. Wiggle your fingers and toes. And circle the wrists and ankles. Stretch your arms up over the head, getting long. Gather your knees into the chest, rocking them around. And take a cat stretch to each side. Once you've done each side, you can come back to center and rub the soles of the feet against each other and the palms of the hands against each other at the same time. Let your feet go, and today bring your hands over your eyes. Opening your eyes into the darkness. May you see what is unseen within yourself. Draw the pinky edges of the hands together as they rise above your face. Slowly releasing them higher and higher until they fall away. Come rocking up to seated. If you brought your journal with you to class, you can get it out now. If not, that's okay. You can also do this exercise in your mind. We'll do a quick write where we don't filter anything that we're saying. Try to keep your pen going, even if it starts writing things like, I don't know what to write, just keep writing. We'll do 1 minute and we'll start with the writing prompt. This is a writing prompt that Dana Faulds uses. You're going to write at the top of the page, "This is what I have to say to you." And you're talking to yourself. This is what I have to say to you. And then go ahead and begin writing anything to yourself that comes through. 10 seconds. And take a deep inhale. If you want yourself to come back to this, you can write "to be continued." Let's seal our series with Om Tare Tutare. No rules, just enjoy it. And any imagery or thoughts that might end up coming through, just notice them.
Thank you.
Inhale deep. Exhale. May the longtime sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. Inhale for Satna. Lift the heart, bow the head, honoring the inside, the outside, sun, moon, everything in between, all one. Sat Nam. Your final homework is to read your writing out loud to yourself someday. Maybe tomorrow, maybe in 2 years, whenever it comes up again. Thank you all so much for doing this course with me. It's so amazing to be here with you.